We also have strong ongoing cooperation through training and negotiations on global trade issues, including at WTO, to protect and promote the legitimate interests of developing countries, especially the LDCs. Our trade ministers met here in New Delhi last week. This provided a useful opportunity to discuss ways to expand our economic and commercial cooperation. Earlier, the third meeting between India and the 8 regional economic communities of Africa was held in New Delhi in August 2014. This summit takes place at a time of momentous developments in the international arena. 2015 has been a landmark year for global issues. Just last month, the international community adopted a set of sustainable development goals as part of the broader 2030 agenda for sustainable development at the UN General Assembly. India and Africa have worked together to develop a common understanding of our core priorities for an inclusive economic growth, to eradicate poverty and allocate adequate resources for sustainable development. Our similar and shared experiences and struggles translate into similar scale of challenges and concerns, both at the level of national priorities and collective interests in an increasingly globalized world. There is considerable synergy between the priorities being pursued by the Government of India and Africa's Agenda 2063. Today, India and Africa are engaged in an equally vital struggle, a struggle to eliminate poverty and uplift our people. All of us are working to ensure provision of health care, education, employment, access to modern energy services, infrastructure, and connectivity between resources and markets. Blue or ocean economy, maritime security, and counter-terrorism are also areas where we need to focus more. I'm sure that we will continue to work together in promoting the interests of the LDCs, LLDCs, and SIDs as part of their partnership. Excellencies, we have just celebrated the 70th year of the establishment of the United Nations. Although Indians and Africans comprise nearly 2.5 billion people, our nations continue to be excluded from appropriate representation in the institutions of global governance. India and Africa can no longer be excluded from their rightful place of the permanent membership of the UN Security Council. How can we expect legitimacy from a governance structure that excludes the entire African continent and a country which represents 1/6 of humanity? India will further scale up its participation in UN peacekeeping operations, including by providing training for African peacekeepers at our facilities in India and in the field. In view of the fast-growing linkages of such terrorist groups across the globe, we must step up our cooperation through intelligence exchange, training, and other measures to counter this menace. We also hope that the international community will cooperate with urgency to adopt the Comprehensive Convention Against International Terrorism.